Hello and very welcome to the second tutorial in the series of tutorials for the Lampy console. In this tutorial, we will talk about the user interface. The console utilizes an easy-to-use and intuitive graphical user interface. This tutorial will explain the basics of finding your way around the UI in the internal as well as the external display. At first, let's have a look at the top toolbar. The top toolbar is also divided into three parts. The left part shows buttons that control the programming interface, and we will get back to these buttons in a later tutorial. The center part shows the title of the current screen, or, if applicable, the current command including possible options. If it is showing the current command, you can also click on it to choose options. If the current command is displayed in red, it is invalid or missing information. The right part of the top toolbar shows the main buttons to navigate through the user interface. Let's have a look at these main buttons. The first button is called the magic wand and opens a context-sensitive menu. If the magic wand button is grayed out, it is not accessible. The second button is called the virtual executor button. Clicking on the virtual executor button opens the virtual executor screen. On the left, this contains executors that can contain a scene. And on the right, you have different faders for direct access to chaser speed, the grandmaster controlling all fixtures brightness, global FX speed, and global FX size. Should any of these faders not be at its default value, the button will be shown in orange like it was before. Now that the FX size is at the default value, the button is green, indicating that there's no changes in the virtual executor view. Let's move the grandmaster slider down to zero. As we move it down, you see that the button changes to an orange icon, indicating that there's a fader active in the virtual executor's view. As soon as we reach 0%, you see that the button turns red. The button will turn red if any of the speed faders is set to zero or pause, indicating that there's a change going on in the virtual executor's window that might affect your show file. The third button is the home button. The home button basically brings you to the interface for all your programming. Within the home screen, there's different tabs for fixtures, groups, presets, the values, and effects. The fourth button opens the side menu, which is used to open the patch window, fader overview, DMX output. You can also save your show file in here. You can enter the setup menu. You can lock the console, or you can shut down or reboot the console. Let's have a look at the content area. The content area is below the top toolbar and the bottom toolbar. The content area is used to display windows and dialogues based on the selection made from the top toolbar, side menu, or other user interface elements. Next, let's have a look at the bottom toolbar. The bottom toolbar is used to show playback fader labels on the left side, playback page and multifunction fader mode on the right part, and the master fader label on the far right side. We will talk about these in detail in the corresponding sections at a later point. Next, let's have a look at the external screen. Without the dongle, the external screen will simply display a fixture view. You can zoom in and out in here, and the zooming and positioning is independent from the internal fixture view. In the bottom left part of the screen, you will see a timecode disabled button, which can be used to enable or disable timecode. Then we have the current date and time. On the right to the current date and time, there's a button to switch multi-fader function modes. On the right side of that, you will see the labels for the multifunction faders. In case you're using a Lampy 40, the layout of the bottom part of the external screen changes. Now on the left side, you will see the labels for multifunction faders 11 to 20 and multifunction faders 21 to 30. In the center, there's a button to switch between the multifunction fader modes. On the top right part, you will see the multifunction faders 1 to 10. In the bottom part, you will see date and time, and on the right, you will have the option to enable or disable the timecode. As soon as a Lampy dongle is connected to the console, it will unlock multiple other views on the external screen. The available views are fixtures. As mentioned before, this is a fixture view that is independent from the internal screen in terms of positioning and zooming. But now you will notice that on the top right, you can also select the second sheet. This functionality is only available with a Lampy dongle and also available on the internal screen. The second button shows an overview of groups and presets. Groups and presets can also be selected and deselected by clicking on them. The third view displays the virtual executor screen that we just saw on the internal screen as well. This screen basically mimics the internal screen, but is very useful if you have a busking setup and need quick live access while still being able to program or alter your show file on the internal screen. The fourth button opens a queue list view, which will always show the selected queue list. The fifth button displays a DMX output view, which shows DMX output data sorted by universe. And the sixth button is basically just in case you're bored, so you can play a tiny bit of solitaire. So that was a basic and quick overview of the Lampy's user interface. I hope you liked this tutorial, and I hope to see you again next time when we'll actually begin using the console. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.